Hi, I'm Jessica, here with Cam and Arpana. We're at the 24th Annual Canadian Young Speakers for Agriculture Competition at the Royal Agriculture Winter Fair.
The competition brings together speakers from across Canada with a passion for agriculture. For this year's competition, speakers were required to write a 5 to 7 minute speech on one of the following five topics.
The topics include leadership in agriculture, biofuels and the future of agriculture, organics, going green, and agriculture around the world. Let's check it out.
I'm here today with Colleen O'Shea, a finalist for the competition. Colleen just gave her speech on leadership in agriculture. She's from Granton, Ontario, and lives on a vegetable and berry farm. Colleen, why did you choose the topic of leadership in agriculture?
I just think leadership in agriculture is something that we can all be involved in, and it's just an industry that I'm very passionate about, growing up on a farm all my life, and I think that everyone, no matter if you're from a farm or not, can do something little to contribute to our industry and to improve it, and so therefore we all can be leaders in agriculture, and I wanted to bring that message forward to everyone.
How do you feel your speech went today?
I was very happy with it. Obviously, there's a little bit of nerves going, but once I got up there and got rolling, I'm pretty comfortable with speaking in front of people, so it's pretty laid back. Yeah, I was very happy with it.
And what was the main message you wanted the audience to take away from your speech today?
Like I said, my speech was on leadership in agriculture and how everyone can do something, and if that's as small as going to your grocery store and looking for the Grown in Canada label, or going to farmers markets, or going to restaurants that you know serve only locally produced food. I just want everyone to be able to do something like that. And so, that was my main message, is everyone can just do a little action to contribute to the bigger picture.
That's great. And what personal benefit did you get from doing this competition?
I'm just, like I said, I've been involved in a lot of public speaking functions with the Canadian National Exhibition Ambassador of the Fairs and 4-H definitely, and so it's just something I enjoy doing, and I enjoy talking about agriculture and industry I'm passionate about, and so it was just another opportunity to develop my skills and, have a little bit of fun in the competition along the way.
And what other exhibits at the Royal are you going to check out while you're here?
Currently I'm going to jet off to the Hereford show ring because our farm is showing as we speak. So I got to go get changed into my show clothes and go help out there. And I'll definitely be checking out the Journey for Your Good Health, the University of Guelph display that's here this year. It looks very, very interesting.
Thanks so much, Colleen, and enjoy the rest of the Royal.
Thanks, Jess.
I'm here with Aric from Goderich, Ontario. Aric grew up on a chicken farm, and he's here with us today to talk about his performance. Aric, what topic did you choose?
Well, Cam, today I chose the topic of where Canada stands in terms of agriculture.
For everybody watching, what was the main message you wanted them to take away from your speech?
Well, in my speech I focused on supply management, and I kind of outlined the benefits and what it's done for agriculture in Canada. So I want them to take home the fact that supply management is indeed a great economic platform. Mm-hmm.
Do you think that it would be important for other sectors of agriculture to engage in supply management?
To a certain degree, it only works for certain industries. They have, back when chickens and dairy supply management started, they tried to apply it to other industries, but it just didn't work for them at the time. So it depends on the situation, I would say.
What benefits did you get from doing this speech?
Well, it definitely made me come out of my shell and, practice my public speaking, which is always a great personal skill to have, for sure.
Did you learn anything new that you didn't know?
From other people's speeches, definitely. Oh yeah, there's a lot of great material going through people's speeches, for sure.
Indeed. Just to send off question, what exhibits are you going to see while you're not competing here today?
I'd love to check out the cattle barn. That's always a great time out there. And just maybe shop around, get some souvenirs, get some food. Great food here.
Thanks, Aric. I think I'm also going to check out the cattle barn a little later today.
Hi, I'm here with Tammy Fischer from Teeswater, Ontario. She just finished giving a speech on the future of agriculture. How do you feel about being here?
It's good. It's a lot of fun, and I think it's a great experience and a good way to get my message out to the agriculture community.
What message did you want to give to the audience today?
Well, I spoke with the future of agriculture and the local food movement and how supporting local farmers and buying local food is the future of agriculture.
And why do you feel this is important to the agricultural sector?
I feel it's important because we're constantly competing with imports, which can produce their food for cheaper because they don't have the same inputs that we need to do here in Canada. So it's very hard for Canadian farmers to compete, and I think that it's important for us to recognize that and make sure that we really support our Canadian farmers.
How has giving this speech benefited you?
Well, it's a great experience, like I said, and a great opportunity to enhance my public speaking skills and meet new friends and network and that kind of stuff.
So while you're waiting to find out the results, what exhibits do you plan to see?
I think I'm going to go check out the dairy show as well as the 4-H field crops. I entered my wheat sheaf, so I'm going to go see how it did and just tour around and see what there is to see.
That's great. Thanks so much for your time.
This is Cam here. And I'm with Kayla Getzinger, the winner from this year's competition. And she hails from Stony Plain, Alberta, from a small beef farm. Kayla, what does winning this award mean to you?
It means a lot for my province and my club that I'm happy to be a member of for 6 years. And I'm just so happy to say I could do it.
For everybody out there, tell us what your topic was.
My topic was agriculture around the world, where does Canada stand?
And what do you think stands out about your particular speech?
I think it was the personal input I really put into it. I was really passionate, and my speech did change every single time I said it, so I really knew my speech, and it was just very personal.
Perfect. Where did the inspiration come from for your speech?
I know. It was in Alberta when I had to do the provincial 4-H speech competition. My topic was community, and I just thought agriculture in Canada stemmed from community.
Fantastic. What do you plan on doing to celebrate?
Tonight, I'm going to my hotel, and I'm going to sleep because I have jet lag.
Fantastic. I'm here with Kayla Getzinger, this year's champion for the Canadian Young Speakers for Agriculture competition.
After the preliminary round, the judges debated for nearly 25 minutes before deciding on the finalists, a true testament to the talent and skills of all the speakers today.
Despite being given a choice of only 5 topics, the variety in the speeches was outstanding.
Clearly, all the young speakers here had a heated passion for agriculture. This is Arpana, Cam, and Jess reporting from the Royal Agricultural Winter Fair.